Hi there, this is Sarah from Sarah's Hand Embroidery Tutorials. In this video, I will show you 6 different ways to stitch pine trees and decorate them with beads. The first one is an easy and quick way to create a block of green color using the surface satin stitch. Use 3 strands to work the stitch. The surface satin stitch looks similar to the satin stitch but uses lesser thread, which is an advantage. You would start from one end of the tree and move to the other end. And then you would come back up from the same side that you went down at and move to the other side. It's always better to start from the broader side, working towards the tapering end. And that is our first pine tree. The next one is worked using the fern stitch. You can stitch this from the top to bottom or the bottom to the top. This stitch is usually worked horizontally, representing the branches of the tree. Still, I decided to give it a slightly different approach, and I hope you like it. Thank you. I prefer to work the outermost sides first and then move to the ones in between. If you want to layer it with more rows of fern stitches, use another color and work over this layer to cover the gaps. The third one is worked using the looped stem stitch. This stitch is great if you want to add dimension to the tree. Make rows of looped stem stitches starting from the broader end and work towards the top. After finishing one row, start the next one right above it with a slight gap. Continue this process till the top of the tree. The fourth one is made using the lazy daisy stitch. I have worked a zigzag pattern on this tree. Work the lazy daisy in a horizontal row in each tree section. Start from the broader side to move towards a tapering end. I work every alternating section first. You can work in whichever way you find comfortable. Once the entire tree is done, it creates a zigzag texture that reminds of a Christmas tree. The fifth tree is a simple one with horizontal sections. The buttonhole shading stitch looks perfect to use here. I fill each section with a row of the blanket stitch. The subsequent rows encroach into the previous row. As you see, I begin from the bottom. You can place the stitches as close as you want or spread it out. You can also use different shades of green for each section, giving it a gradient effect. The encroaching can be short or long. A longer encroaching will give it a more filled effect. the finished tree will look more or less like this. The last tree is made using the feather stitch. I work on each horizontal branch using small feather stitches. It looks really nice to me. Think about layering this layer with more feather stitches in another shade. I work the feather stitch on the topmost and do a back stitch on the spine. Finish working the feather stitch on the other side too. You can also think about stitching the outline using the back stitch. Now let's work the trunk of all the trees. The best way is to use the satin stitch. Thank you. all the trees are done. Now let us decorate them and turn them into beautiful Christmas trees. I will work on two trees with beads. Think about adding your own decorations and jewels to deck up the trees. I use golden beads on the feather stitch one. I scatter them around, filling them with golden color. I like it. What do you think? Let's do another tree. The Lazy Daisy tree looks interesting by providing me with the grooves to place the red beads. I hope you liked all these trees. Drop me a like and share the video if you have enjoyed it. Also, check out our bookstore for more seasonal patterns. The link is in the description. Thank you so much for watching.